Let's say you want the perfect TV. What exactly would that look like? Well, it would probably have jaw-dropping image quality, fast and smooth refresh rates, and a clean design language that will fit into any room. It's funny then that this thing behind me ticks all of those boxes. Allow me to introduce you to the LG C10 OLED, an absolutely stunning display that's got a lot to offer, but a very large price tag. So in this video, we're gonna go through all of the pros and cons, and ultimately give you my recommendation on whether you should buy it or not. But first, a quick word from our sponsor, Corsair and the Dark Core RGB Pro. This RGB gaming mouse has it all. Incredible precision thanks to the 18,000 DPI pixel sensor, wireless latency under 1 millisecond thanks to Corsair's Slipstream technology, and a comfort level that will let you play all day and night. Customize it your way with 8 programmable buttons and 2 side grips, charged with USB Type-C, and then set up profiles with Corsair's Epic IQ software. Check it out with the links down below. The LG C10 then, what do you need to know? Well, firstly, that this is a review unit that was provided by LG for this video, but secondly, that this really isn't your Black Friday bargain from Asda. No, this is very much a top tier set for those that want the very best, with headline specifications such as full 4K resolution, a true OLED panel for infinite contrast and perfect blacks, and then future-proof tech such as HDMI 2.1 and eARC support. All of this very much comes at a cost, and as you'd expect with large format TVs, the price does go up exponentially as you go up in screen size. Though having said this, it's great that this is the first year that LG are now offering a 48-inch version, which is fantastic for the PC gamers out there, but also those of you that want to have a more modest-sized TV in your living room. The CX, or C10 as it's officially known, is a beautiful bit of kit, with a remarkably thin design and a very low center of gravity that does help in its stability. It is quite reflective though, and you'll definitely notice this if you place it near a window. You might have to shut some curtains if you plan on watching it during the day, but with matte coatings that you can get on other televisions, they usually impact image quality. So if you're after the ultimate TV, I'll definitely take the trade-off here. Basic navigation is handled with LG's hefty smart remote, which can be used to quickly change inputs or settings, open up applications, or now even control your smart home, which is really useful if you've got a smart bulb or two, but there's no Google Home in sight. HDMI 2.1 support is actually baked into this thing right at the box. It may require an update to get there, but essentially what this is actually going to give you is 4K at up to 120 frames a second. So if you're gonna grab a next generation console or maybe an Ampere graphics card from Nvidia, then chances are those will support HDMI 2.1 and you'll be able to play 4K gaming at 120 FPS. Oh, I can't wait. eARC support, meanwhile, allows you to hook this up to a compatible receiver and then pass through object-based audio like Dolby Atmos directly to your receiver. But by far the most impressive thing about this C10 OLED is the image quality, as it doesn't matter what you throw on this thing, it's quite outstanding actually just how good it looks. Even filming my own content, I've got a pretty good monitor upstairs, but when you bring it down here and actually look back, you're blown away. It's incredible. Unlike traditional TVs that use an LCD panel with a backlight system attached, OLED is a self-emitting technology, so every single pixel produces its own color and projection light, which produces such a deep and vibrant level of color, but it also has the ability to make itself as bright or dark as it likes. So this is what gives you that infinite level of contrast, as the minimum brightness becomes zero or off, so you can enjoy movies and TV in a way that you've just never experienced before. This also solves the backlight bleeding system that you're typically going to see on pretty much all other HDR displays, and you're not limited to certain hot pockets of light or dark. You don't get any of those horrible blooming zones. But it's not completely flawless though. I mean, even with OLED, if you have some really bright text next to complete darkness, it's not bleed, so to speak, but you do get a little bit of light leakage just around a few different pixels if you look at it up close. But as soon as you go back and actually see it in your normal viewing position, then it pretty much is as close to a perfect experience as you're gonna get when it comes to contrast. It is fantastic. What is noticeable though is the fact that OLED isn't quite as bright as the very best LCDs on the market, and there's quite a big difference actually. This will max out at around about 700 to 800 nits depending on the mode that you're using, whereas the very best from someone like Samsung is actually over around about 2000 nits. And I'm not saying you actually want 2000 nits blowing in your face the whole time, but if you're wanting the most impactful HDR, then having excellent blacks is half the story, but then having really bright highlights is the other. So it's something you need to be aware of. Something else you do need to be aware of is the fact that OLEDs are known for their image retention after a period of time. And I don't think that it's gonna really be a problem to 99% of people that buy TVs like this, because they've now got sort of like built-in pixel refreshers so that you're not gonna get any of these stuck pixels. But you should be aware that when you're using your TV, try not to leave it on for an extended period of time, just to alleviate the risk. Let's move on to the gaming scene though, as for me, this is a huge factor when it comes to choosing a new TV set. And we've already talked about the 4K 120 support over HDMI, but the thing is, while this is definitely gonna be super crazy to experience, I wouldn't say that this is a real world selling point for most of us, and it's probably a future feature rather than one you can experience straight away. So instead, you should be a lot more excited about the low input lag and blurring on this thing, as this is what's going to make the difference to absolutely everybody that uses it. You're looking at around 13 to 14 milliseconds of input lag in game mode, which is basically all but imperceivable in the real world when using a controller, and the panel has a rate of response time of around about 1 millisecond. The two of these, combined with the sublime HDR image quality, makes playing The Last of Us Part 2 an unreal experience. Well, maybe it's the opposite actually, maybe it's quite real, it definitely feels it, just minus the zombies. When you hook this up to your PC, you also get a G-Sync compatible display, so image tearing and stuttering are massively reduced when set up correctly. Just be mindful that you need to go directly into an HDMI port on the TV, rather than plumbing into an AV receiver or soundbar. AMD FreeSync is also supported too, for both consoles and PC, just note that this does require an update to enable. Oh, and unlike the days of old, HDMI 2.1 will automatically enable the TV to go in and out of game mode as and when required, without you needing to touch a button, which is really neat. Brand new for 2020 is what LG are calling the Alpha 9 Generation 3 processor, which should give you better processing, which is going to impact image quality and make it slightly better when compared to last year. But LG have also introduced something that they're calling a filmmaker mode. This turns off all the motion processing that manipulates the way a movie feels, so you can watch in the way that the director intended, or at least that's the whole idea. In the real world, I'm still a bit of a manual tweaker to get the best from both worlds, but it is cool that you have so many different options available, and I'm sure you're gonna find one that you love. Over 50% of people that are gonna be buying a TV like this probably will use the inbuilt speakers. And if you are in that camp, you'd be glad to know that we have things like Dolby Atmos support in here, so you get a little bit of spatial sound. Obviously, it's not as good as a proper dedicated setup, but it's not bad, it's a start, and the actual audio quality is way more than listenable. It's very enjoyable, but it should go without saying that if you do want to get the most out of your movies or anything that you're watching, whether it's a soundbar or a dedicated AV receiver and home theatre setup, that is what I'd recommend to just get the best experience. Oh, and if you do want to know what I'm using here, what these speakers are, the AV receiver or the PC, any of that good stuff, I'll leave my Amazon affiliate links to everything featured down in that description below. So ignoring the unfathomable pricing of 8K TVs or the unnecessary style pricing that you get with LG's more expensive OLEDs, on paper, this is probably the best TV you can buy right now. But make no mistake, it will still cost you a hefty sum. My suggestion is therefore to wait a little bit until it's been out a couple of months and then start saving a bit off the asking price, or even consider last year's model, which hasn't actually changed too much and would offer better value for money, assuming you can still buy one, of course. In terms of what I would do if I was buying a brand new TV tomorrow, well, I'd definitely strongly consider the C10, but I'd also pay very close attention to LG's B10, as this is cheaper, the panel is more or less the same, you don't get the same processor, but whether that matters is, I guess it depends on what processing options you actually leave on anyway. If you're gonna get more or less the same experience for a lot less money, that's worth considering, right? At the end of the day, if you've got the cash to drop on this sort of TV, then you really shouldn't hesitate to pick up the C10, as it really is the ideal TV. Gorgeous image quality, future-proof with eARC and HDMI 2.1 support, and then it's perfect for gaming with both its low input lag and adaptive sync technologies. Realistically, what's not to love? If you have enjoyed this video, then please hit the like button as it really does help out. Once again, a massive thank you to LG for actually supplying this TV for this review. It is much appreciated. Let me know your thoughts on it down in the comment section below. And if you do want to check out current pricing, as always, you can do so with my Amazon affiliate links, and you can find those down below. And of course, while you're down there, don't forget to check out Corsair and their epic Dark Core RGB Pro. If you're after a do-it-all wireless gaming mouse, then look no further. With 9 zones of RGB lighting, a super responsive PixArt sensor, and sub 1 millisecond slipstream wireless technology, there's never been a better tool for your gaming desires. Customize it your way with 8 programmable buttons and 2 side grips, and play for up to 50 hours on a single charge. It's even available in an SE flavor, packing Qi wireless charging. Check it out with the links down below. Thank you so much for watching, I really appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one.